Hello. So tonight I am doing a carving, and this one will be for t-shirts. I'm carving MDF, quarter inch MDF. Hello. And I am carving a Pegasus design. I'm not sure that I'm going to carve the whole thing on Instagram Live tonight, but I'll do it for at least an hour. So I'm going to get work in here. Put my camera over on this side, so I'm going to scoot over. I'm pretty excited to get into carving the wings on this guy. I think it's got some nice opportunities for creating patterns. What animal is this? This is it's a Pegasus, so it's a horse with wings. Alright, can I get in the eye here? Get this little flower pattern around the eye carved out. I'll do those three marks. I'll move that to there, and then this over here. It's a little bit larger than what I've been carving recently, so I have to organize my carving desk appropriately. Alright, so round this the little eye flower piece. These small areas. I like to do some of the most delicate areas first. Like the faces. I
around the eyes. So right now I'm just kind of outlining
the lines that I want to draw,
that I want to carve. And then carving away what doesn't need to be there and clearing out.
Thin this out a little bit.
Top of this
eyebrow line, that one.
This looks like a different type of character than I've done before. It's a Pegasus.
So it's something I've done, like unicorns and stuff.
It's more realistic, maybe.
Is this for a t-shirt?
Yes, it is. I'm doing a, it's a Pegasus design for a t-shirt. Hello, hello.
Now I gotta clear out that little middle piece.
So I'm looking for my larger U gouge. Have to go in and gently take out that middle slot.
Gently, very gently.
So now I'm going to carve away the nose area. Thank you.
We'll leave a little information down at the bottom of the muzzly area.
So I'm going to
carve that away. And not much,
just like a line or two.
Just like that, yeah. That's enough.
And I'm going to clear out the rest.
Hello, how are you?
Okay. Now up to the ears. And so the backs of the ears, let's see, I'm just going to do it like
something inside there,
and then that insides are gonna stay black. Round those edges off, and then this one.
So I'm gonna do a little mark down inside. And now for the hair. He's got like a fun little hairdo going on. I'm going to be real careful not to take out too much in the hair.
Excuse me.
As I get closer to moving underneath that wing,
I'm gonna take less and less material away. So it gives it the illusion of it's going into shadow as it gets this over in this direction.
So precise and satisfying. Thank you for your work. Thank you for sharing it with us.
No, thank you for watching. Thank you for enjoying. Give him a little flowing mane here.
Because what's a good Pegasus without a good flowing mane?
So here, once again, it's very close to being under the wing, so I want to be careful to not
take away too much material
in this area, because I want it to give the illusion of shadow. And
this horse has very short hair,
I imagine. I'm not sure. I've never met a Pegasus. So I don't want to, I'm not going to do my typical fur pattern, even though it is hairy. I'm just going to
keep my line work consistent
as I work through this. Once again, we're underneath this leg, so I don't want to take away too much material. I'm gonna taper those lines out. And then on the leading edge of this leg, I'm gonna take out a nice big chunk. I'm really gonna clear all that out, but for now, there's gonna be this nice leading edge.
So I can move down
to the leg that's behind
this leg right here.
So, carve out the leading edge. Fold it around the bottom of that edge there.
Keeping my mark, making it organized. Okay.
So here I am now. I want to wrap around the form of this leg. happy little front foot. So this area right here, on the back side of this leg, is going to be like hatch marks. So I carved that area that I wanted to be gray, and I shaped it into the right shape. And then I just go through and I break it up with straight lines. And there's a ton
of different ways that I could have done that.
For that area, that's how I decided to do it.
I could have done like a zigzaggy thing.
But really, I just wanted like a gray stripe along the inside edge of this Pegasus leg. Furry bit right here.
And the hoof is going to be black.
So I'm going to leave that black, but I'm going to go like this
around the edge.
Okay.
Now to clear that area out. Now to clear that area out.
I want to carve deep enough, but I don't want to carve too deep where I rip the material. So there's some little happy areas that I'm going to leave. Like up there. I'm just going to leave that mark making.
I don't like everything to be so controlled.
So I want to leave a little bit of the history of the, you know, creating this piece in the board. But I want to control the areas that are important to me and let the areas that are not so important be a little freer.
So that's that. And I want to knock it down just a tad because it's got some pretty good hills and valleys in here. So I'm just going to take a flatter U-gouge, a wider U-gouge.
I'm just going to knock those little areas down so they don't print. I'm going to ink it up.
That should be good enough. The belly time.
Alright, so I'm going to get this underside of the belly. I'm going to start with a thin line there. And I'm going to be careful here to not take away too much because I'm on the underside of two things. I'm on the other side of the belly and then also underneath the leg itself. those carving marks. I'm probably going to go back in and reinforce the back edge of that leg. But for now, I'm just going to see what my carving mark can make me do as I work with the form and take away little bits of material here and there. It's easy to take away more later, but it's hard to put material back. And I try not to do it. I try to avoid it at all costs. Only if it's absolutely necessary will I go about that process. I don't know if I need to. I got implied lines, so I'm gonna leave that. I'm just gonna come there, get a little bit closer. Okay. We have a nice zigzag line, a gray zigzag line here. Pick up the zigzag, I'm just gonna double back on the marks I just made. Double back. If I'm going to take too much away, we're going underneath the wing again. Actually, I might leave that underneath the wing area until I've actually got the wing carved out in that spot. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and go for that right now. So far, let's move it up. Yeah, there we go. So far, I've got this working. I've got the little Pegasus mostly carved out. I'm going to work on the wing right now. So I'm just going to dive on in. Not quite sure what to do. I've got it scribbled out. I've got notes really written to myself on here. I'm going to carve away the leading edge. I've got intentions when I draw these, and I know roundabouts how I'm going to do it. But I'm never 100% sold until I've actually made the carving mark. Wing to look pretty feathery. I'm just going to take out little bits. Of the
smaller feathers that make up the interior of the wing.
Until I get all the way to the bottom. I like the texture that it makes. I'm going to come a couple different directions so it doesn't look so uniform.
Hi, how are you?
How long does it usually take me to carve one of these? So this is one of my t-shirt designs. The t-shirt designs take a little bit longer for me to carve because I have to worry about the outer edges. With the other ones, I cut the outer edges first. This one, I suspect, will take me between like 2 and 3 hours, maybe 4-ish. But I'd say between 2 and 3 hours for this one. But that's after, you know, 10 years of constant carving. So I've got this, I've got it down.
Front edge of that wing is done. Now the more fun begins.
And that's actually carving some feather texture in. These little ones radiate away from a point.
And they're just a small amount.
And these ones. Do the same, but they're a little bit bigger. So I'm gonna carve away the outlines of them. And then I'm gonna go back in and decide what the inside looks like. Now with these, I've got the,
you know, the basic scribble working
underneath, but I'm kind of really drawing. A better mark with my tool as I move along. I don't want to carve everything away on these. Because this is just going to be a black and white image, so I want to think of it as a black and white image.
So I might do this inner layer of feathers, since I've got this white, I might do that black. And then some more, like some white feathers deeper into the wing. And then some more darker feathers.
But I don't want it to all be like
lighter colored. I want there to be some large black areas as well.
Bottom of the wings, this wing here. with these feathers, this layer of feathers. They get smaller and smaller until they kind of just blend in to what I've already carved. Right, so I'm going to do like a little, just a little spine to these feathers. And they're not going to connect. Just a little spine all the way down. Until it makes sense for me not to anymore. That's what the inside of these ones are going to look like. I'm going to do like a little, break up these larger areas. It was bugging me. I'm going to do this layer of feathers here now. I'm going to do the same thing. We're kind of cut away the outline. Why do I wear a glove on one hat, on one hand?
So the reason I wear a glove on one hand is because the tool that I'm using puts a lot of pressure onto the palm of my hand. You can see where the tool's kind of worn away the fabric, the leather. And it's just because that's where I hold the tool. I hold it right there in the palm of my hand. So it keeps my hands from blistering and allows me to carve longer before my hands start to hurt from all the pressure that I'm putting onto that one little spot on the palm of my hand. So, short answer, it's so my hands don't hurt. I don't think I should keep these ones darker
black like I have carved these ones. So I'm going to
break these ones up a little bit more. No problem. Thank you
and thank Hayden for watching.
So I'm going to break these up.
I'm making this one a little bit more white than the previous layer. next layer of feathers. I think I'm going to do the rest of the feathers like this. I like these, but I think it's too much. And I'm going to leave a lot of this the mark making that I have in there. So I'm gonna do this next layer of feathers, much like that layer of feathers.
But first, I'm just gonna go through and I'm gonna do the same thing I did last time. I need to outline each one. And these ones are gonna be a little bit bigger.
And then I'm going to carve the whites out now, the inside of them out.
I had a little happy little, missed a little spot there. You can't really see, I'll pull it closer. Where is it? Right there.
Missed a little spot there.
But I like it. I'm going to keep it because it's going to print. I like little areas like that. You know, I'm not intending to make, but it's a perfect little
evidence of the process. How much time would I spend carving a piece like this?
Well, this is one of my t-shirt blocks. The t-shirt blocks take a little bit longer than my carved and painted pieces to carve out.
Just because once I'm done with the interior carving, I have to go and do the exterior carving.
I imagine this piece is going to take me between 2 and 3 hours.
It's impossible to know.
But I imagine.
I've been at it for just under an hour now so far. And I've got this much carved out so far. You know, it feels like I'm getting close to being done.
I've still got a long ways to go, I believe.
Especially considering that this is going to be a lot of patterning.
And I have
been carving almost every day for, you know, 10 years.
So. I've gotten quick at what I do.
All right, one more layer of feathers on this particular wing. Well, this one is going to be, this particular carving is going to be for t-shirts. So it's going to be very affordable for you. It's just going to be $20 for the shirt plus whatever shipping it works out to be. What kind of wood do I prefer to carve? This wood is it's MDF, so I generally carve MDF for most of the things I'm working on. I have a minute and 10 seconds remaining in this live video, so I'll sign back on. I wasn't planning on it, but I'll sign back on and keep working on this. But Instagram Live only allows me to be on for an hour at a time. So I will sign back on and keep working. So if you're interested to see how this finishes out, come back and check out the rest of the live carving video when I sign back on in just in a couple minutes here. I'm just gonna leave it right there for now. I'll pull that back into the frame for the last 15 seconds.